let's start our warm-up with our hands on our waists, and let's just kick our legs forward. Nice little kicks, opposite, first the right, then the left. This is just to get the circulation increased throughout the body, to get the blood flow increased throughout the body as well. Nice easy kicks. That's right. If your family don't know that you've started an exercise program, don't tell them, surprise them. Exercise along with me for 2 weeks. And then go out for a walk with them or go for some exercises. Tell them one day, let's go down and try some sit-ups. And you'll show them up. And then you can show them that you've been exercising. Let it be a surprise for them. It'll be a pleasant surprise. They're only doing it because they love you. I know I was terrible to my mom. I used to always get after her to try and start her on an exercise program. Only because I cared, though. Let's incorporate some arm movements now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Out to the side, you're reaching with your arms. There you go. Just reaching at shoulder height. Again, just working on increasing the circulation. Keep kicking with your legs. There you go. After our warm-up, we move into our cardiovascular section, and that's when we branch off to the beginner and the intermediate levels. So you choose the level at which you would like to work. During our SOS section, which comes up after our cardiovascular section, we also do a beginner and intermediate level. Today we're going to concentrate on the abdomen region, on the tummy muscles, and then it's our cool down, which we all do together. That's our full format. Hope you enjoy the program. Just do what you can. Let's count down to stretch. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Point both toes to the same direction, and slowly, keeping our knees straight, let's roll down till you place your hands on the floor, or if you can't reach the floor, just as far as you can. Feel a nice stretch in through the backs of your legs, both legs, and bend your front knee. Now feel a nice stretch in through the calf of your front leg, as well as more of a stretch in the front of your back leg now. Straighten out your knee. Get the same stretch that we had initially. And bend your front knee again. Let's do that once more. Straighten out. And come on up to the other side. Walk your way around the front. Turn your feet. There you go. Same thing. Both legs straight. And bend your knee. And both legs straight. Bend your knee. Just a nice stretch for the legs. And straighten. And bend. And straighten and walk your hands to the front. Both toes facing to the front. Bend your knees and roll up, keeping your chin on your chest. Roll up your spine. There you go. Walk your feet in. We're going to start our cardiovascular section by marching on the spot. Okay? I hope that you're all wearing footwear. That's very important, because when we will be doing some jumping, intermediate people especially, it's more comfortable to have footwear on. The surface you're exercising on is also very important. By that I mean you should be exercising on a well-carpeted area, or you should be exercising on a mat, something that has a bit of a give when you jump. But the beginners don't do any jumping at all, but they still should wear footwear. Now, when we're marching, we land initially on the balls of our feet, but then we roll to our heel. So you roll throughout your foot. Please try and concentrate on doing that throughout the entire cardiovascular section. Please do not stay up on the balls of your feet, because you may develop shin problems. Okay, now that's one thing to watch out for. Second thing is our backs should be flat, and by that I mean that we're not arching, and nor are we slouching. Our backs are nice and flat. So use your hands to position yourself properly so that your back is flat. There you go. And make sure that you're keeping the airflow through this area cleared by keeping your shoulders up and keeping them back. That'll also help cramping. And keep breathing nice and deep. Don't ever take little shallow breaths. Nice deep breaths. Okay, we're going to count down to beginner and intermediate levels. Are you ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Beginners following me in the corner, intermediate people following me here in the center of the screen. What we're doing is we're just hopping from side to side. Beginners are stepping from side to side. And again, we're just working on elevating the heart rate gradually. There you go. Side to side. rolling from the ball of our foot to our heel, very important, and move around as you do the exercises. Here you go. After this section, which is 9 minutes in duration, don't stop now. Come on. Didn't mean to scare you with that. But you have to exercise at least 9 minutes in order to do your heart and lungs any good over a period of time. So you just pace yourselves accordingly. Okay, but after the section, we do take your pulse rate, just to give you an idea as to how hard you're working. So let's concentrate now. Rolling from the balls of our feet to our heels. Backs are flat. Shoulders are up and back and relaxed. Good. Let's count down to change. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Kicking forward. Kick, kick. Beginners are stepping and kicking. There you go. Step, kick. Hands are still on your waist. Your arms are relaxed. Very important. A lot of time, when people first start exercising, they tend to get a lot of tension into their neck area. Now that's because their arms aren't relaxed. So I'll leave your arms resting on your waist for the first few minutes here, just so you can get an idea as to how to relax them, and so we don't create any tension. And kick. If you do find that you're getting stiff in through the neck area, simply take your hands, drop them off your waists, push your palms down. Concentrate on keeping your shoulders down and relaxed. If you don't feel tension, keep your hands on your waist. Let's count down to incorporate arm movements. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and reach, reach, reach. Same arm, same leg. There you go. It's more comfortable for you to do opposite arm and opposite legs. That's fine. Whatever is most natural for you. There you go. Nice, easy reaches. There you go. Feel your heart rates increasing gradually. Keep breathing. Now I'll ask you to count down with me too, for one very important reason. Because that's how you gauge how hard you're working. If you're too tired, too winded to count down with me, then you're working too hard. So let's count down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Keeping out to the side. Out to the side. There you go. Any Highland dancers in the crowd today? Come on. Kick, kick. Remember, roll to your heel. Good. Let's count down to incorporate arm movements. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Reach. Come on. Keep reaching. Arms up at shoulder height. Keep kicking. Uh-oh, here we go. Pick up the pace a bit. Kick. 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 Good. Keep breathing. There you go. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. 3, 2, 1. Kicking your bum. Hands on your waist. Put your heels right up. There you go. Beginners are stepping back. Working the same muscles, working the backs of our legs here. Come on, bring your heels up. Just as high as you can. Come on, try. There you go. Bring them up. And up. Hands on your waist. Concentrate on your breathing. Big breaths, come on. Not bad breaths, big breaths. There we go. Bring your heels up. Pretty basic. Okay, let's incorporate some arm movements. Increase our heart rate. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Reaching forward with our arms. Up overhead. There we go. Really reach. Each time we incorporate arm movements, our heart is having to work harder. So let's reach. Keep going, come on. Reach, reach. Kick your bottom. Work the backs of those legs, come on. Move around the floor. Pick up the pace a bit. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and lunges. There you go. Feet go out and come together. Good. Out. Out. Come on, open your waists. Let's count down to incorporate arm movements. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and reach. Come on, really reach. Use your arms. Get our heart rates up. Less than a minute left now. Come on, push yourselves. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, come on, 2, and 1. Keep moving. Let's take our pulse rates. Keep moving by bending. Find your pulse rate using your first two fingers, either in your wrist or in your neck. Count for 10 seconds, beginning now. Stop counting, keep moving. Now, find the number that you just counted along the side. Find your age along the bottom. Now, where the two meet in the graph should hopefully be somewhere within this blue area. This is just to give you a general idea as to the range that you should be shooting for. It's your first day. Of course, you shouldn't be at this yet. I've got to give you something to work towards. We're off to a commercial break, but please come back. Keep moving. We're going to work our tummy region during our SOS section. See you in a bit. If you'd like to join me down on the floor, we're going to concentrate on working our tummy muscles now. And remember that surprise we have in store for our friends. I'll show you some things you can show them. Let's start by supporting our upper body weight with our hands behind our legs and roll down vertebrae by vertebrae. Very slowly control it. Give your back a nice stretch. Beginners are rolling down too, and they're following us in the corner of the screen. Okay, we're going to start by working our upper abdominal region by doing what are called crunchies. Now, remember some of this terminology so you can impress them with big words. Okay, hands are relaxed behind your head. Your lower back is into the mat. No space there to take pressure off the lower back. And you're coming up and down. But when you come down, your head's not touching like the beginners. Beginners are taking a rest for two. Their heads are actually touching the mats, the floors. Ours aren't. We're coming up and down. And make sure that you are coming up, that you're not coming forward, your eyes are going up. It doesn't matter that you're getting a lot of movement. There's actually not a big movement here. It's the fact that you're isolating the upper abdominal region here. And if you put your hand here, you can actually feel your abdominals working when you come up. Can you feel that right there? Up and up and down. Okay. So now when you want to surprise your friends and family, invite them down. Let's say, well, let's try some sit-ups. Start them off with this one. It's called crunchies. And the position is just as we are now. And it's working your upper abdominal region. There are three areas to your abdominal region, and we're going to go through all three today so you can show them that you've learned something here on the everyday workout. Can you feel it working? How about beginners? Okay, everyone can feel it. Let's count down. 10, keeping our hands there. 9, feel it working. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Keep counting with me. 2, and 1. Your head goes down to the mat. Now we're going to work the lower abdominal region. Now, for people with lower back problems, please do the beginner level. If your back is fine, let's still place our hands beneath our bottom here, just to keep our lower back into the mat. We don't ever want a space right here, okay? We're going to bring our knees up, and then just take them back down, but they're not touching when they come down. You see that? There you go. Beginners are touching, that's right, and they're resting. But intermediate people, you're rolling forward with your knees, and then you're going down, but your feet aren't touching. Okay? Up and down. Up and down. Now I'm going to ask you to put your hands on your lower abdominals, and don't be disillusioned if you have to push a little to find them. It's a problem area for a lot of people. I'm included in that category too. Don't be embarrassed. Let's put our hands there and see what we feel. You have to push down really hard here. There we go. Found them. Okay? Especially if you've had a baby, that tends to be where you'll keep some weight on. That's fine. I can't guarantee that it's going to come off of that area first thing, but we will tone up that area for you if you do this exercise here. There we go. I just call these hip rolls. You can call them whatever you like, and they're for the lower abdominal region. So keep them in mind again for your surprise. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8. Keep your lower back into the mat. 7, 6. Your head can go down if you like. 5. I keep mine up to watch you. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Keep your feet flat on the floor. Now we're going to work the obliques, the side of the abdominal muscles. And what we're going to do is we're simply going to reach with our hands and reach to the other side. So you're trying to ideally touch your heels without moving your waist. Just a nice stretch along your side. So let's pick up the pace now. Reach and reach. Reach and reach. Again, your head can be down. Reach and reach. Feel a nice stretch along the side of your body. Reach and reach. Beginners are reaching and resting. And then reaching and resting. This exercise, I don't know what you could call it. Side reaches, I guess. And again, it's working your obliques. So remember, we did crunches to work our upper abdominal region. We did hip rolls to work our lower abdominal regions. And we did side reaches to work our obliques. So if you throw some of those words and exercises at them, they'll be impressed. And if you keep doing them, you'll be impressed because you'll notice a change. You really will. Stomach is a great region because you'll notice toning in it. Let's count down. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. During this commercial break, if you'd like, slip on a pair of sweatpants, and you're more than welcome to take your runners off for the cool down. Okay, let's start our cool down by rolling down, just like we did during our SOS section, vertebrae by vertebrae, inch by inch. Support your upper body weight with your hands if you have to. Roll down. There you go, arms out at shoulder height. Walk your feet in a bit, your knees are still bent. We're going to concentrate on stretching out the areas that we've just worked, our tummy region. So let's just start by rolling to the side, taking both knees to the right side, and taking our head to the left side. So you're actually looking over to the left. Nice stretch. And come back up to the center, and same thing to the other side. Nice stretch. Feels nice to have your runners off. And if you like, put on a pair of sweatpants just to keep warm. It's very important that you do keep warm after exercising so that you don't get stiff. But if you do get stiff, these are exercises for you to remember to do tomorrow. To the left. Come up to the center again. Nice stretch over to the right. Feel a nice stretch all along your obliques, your waistline here. The other side. Let your head move. Let it roll with your body and relax. Let's do it once more each side. Don't close your eyes. You might fall asleep on me. Music's very, very relaxing. Once more each side now. Last time to the right here. come back to the center. And let's bend both of our knees and bring them up to our chest. And bring both of our arms around our knees and just hold them into our chest. You can get your lower back to come off the mat now. There you go. Feel a nice stretch and through your bottom, through your thighs. There you go. And relax. And let your feet touch the floor. Keep your lower back into the mat. Remember, no spaces here. And then once again, bring your knees into your chest. Take your feet back down. Walk your feet out a bit. And let's slowly roll up just as we came down. Grab behind your knees for support. And let's straighten out our legs. And now for people with lower back problems, keep your knees bent. People whose backs are fine, straighten your legs out. And at shoulder height, just stretch. Your toes are pointed towards the ceiling. You get a nice stretch in the back of your feet. Feel in the bottom of your feet. Stretching at shoulder height. Just reach with your fingertips. Come back to the center. Relax. You should feel a nice stretch through your arms, through your back, through the backs of your legs, and through your feet. Let's try it again. Let's really stretch as far as we can. At shoulder height again. If you can get your chest down to your knees, that's fine. Like so. If not, just reach at shoulder height. Good. And remember, if you have lower back problems, keep your knees bent. And now bending your right knee, cross your left leg over your right, and do the same thing to the other side. Nice, easy stretches. Well, we're out of time for another day. I'd like to thank you for joining me today. And for those of you who are just starting out, thank you for joining us, and please come back. You should be exercising at least 3 times a week. Hope to see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.